Hey guys, welcome to my next video, and in this one I'm gonna show you something what has changed my life forever. It is a NAS storage system. This is the QNAP TS-364. It's a 3-bay storage device, so you can basically put 3 disks in here, and together with that you can have 2 M2 SSDs to do either tiering or caching. So let's cover the basics first. You can insert 3.5-inch disks in here and go up to RAID 5. So you can either have it in RAID 0, RAID 1, or RAID 5 as I do. I am, of course, running the RAID 5 because I want to be super cautious about my data. But if you're not familiar with RAIDs, a RAID is basically like an array of disks where you have data redundancy depending on which RAID you're running. For example, I have a RAID 5 in here, meaning that I have basically 3 disks in here. And I'm also storing the parity information in here. So what this basically means is that you kind of need like 2 disks and one additional one to store the parity. Although the parity is stored like on all the disks. And how this basically works is when any of the disks stop functioning, you can use the additional 2 disks to calculate the data which was on the third disk. It works thanks to the logical operation XOR. So if you're interested in that, I'm sure you can Google it. The total maximum capacity you can store in here is 54 terabytes. I am currently having 10 terabytes of storage in here, and I am using about 2.5 terabytes. The write speed is 271 megabytes per second, and the read speed is 251 megabytes per second. The Q-tier technology with auto-tiering helps you optimize storage efficiently across all your installed storage devices. And you can use the AES encryption to help to keep your data confidential. For anyone not familiar with any NAS system, this is like another computer for you. So it has an operating system and it's running the Intel Celeron. By default, it has 4 gigabytes of RAM, but you can max it up to 16 gigabytes. And there's a million ways how you can use this, as it is like another computer. So you can use it as a multimedia device, so it can basically store all your data and you can access it from various devices like laptops and your TV, for example. You can stream a movie from it, whatever you like. It supports 4K streaming. It has an HDMI 1.4, so you can stream 4K footage in 30 frames per second. Or you can, of course, use it as a web server or basically whatever you like. There is a bunch of applications you can download which can help you out in so many ways. If I wanted to mention each one of them, I would be here for an hour probably. When we come to the ports, the device has 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 USB ports with the transfer speed of 10 gigabits per second, so you can have fast file sharing and intensive data transfer. You also have 1 USB 3.2 Gen 1, the transfer speed of 5 gigabits per second. And here we come to the first disadvantage of this device, which I have noticed, is that the lower USB port is in the front, which I don't really understand, because it could be the one you are using like most of the time when you stick your USB in here, because there is also a quick copy button. So you just put the USB in here and click the copy button, and you can select where it should copy the data. And on the back here, you have the 2 faster USB ports. What's interesting is that it also has support for the Google AI card, which enables photo recognition, so you can kind of store your photos according like what's in them, as you know it, for example, from your iPhone when you search for a term and the AI finds everything related to that term. It also features 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port and an output for a 65-watt PSU. It has integrated Intel UHD graphics, and I'm gonna show you the user interface right now to show you what I have inside here. So here you are.
This is the control center. You simply need to know the IP address of your device and you log in with your username and your password. So what this offers, it's a very nice UI with a bunch of options here. You can access some of the options from like your user profile, for example, locate your NAS, restart or shut it down, or you can log out and so on. Here you have a dashboard so you can see the performance and a lot of options. So when we open the control panel here, here we have a lot of settings for the system, for the users, for the network, and also we can see the applications. So what is important is, for example, the general settings. Of course, here you have system administration, for example. You have the storage and snapshots, some security. You have hardware, power, notification center, where you see all your notifications coming. Then you can also update the firmware, backup, restore. Here you can set up copying from an external device, for example. You see the system status. You have a resource monitor, logs, and the license center, for example. So here we'll go to storage and snapshots because I think that's the most interesting page. And here you can see all the disks you have installed. So for example, here we see I have three HDDs, two of them Seagate, one of them VDC, and I have two M2 NVMe SSDs, both 500 gigabytes, and the disks are all 6 terabytes. So we see the health of the disks here. We see the storage pool on the right side. And if we go here to the storage and snapshots and we click on our data volume, as you can see, I only have one volume here. We see some other stats here. We see, for example, how much space we have already used. And if we close it and click on the storage pool, here is where it gets interesting. Because I've talked about the RAID groups, so here you can see I have the two M2 SSDs in RAID 1 and the remaining 3 disks in RAID 5 we talked about. Here I have also enabled auto-tiering. And here you see some stats for that. And if you're asking what auto-tiering is, you can always click on the help button here. Here you see the different RAID groups and everything explained. So it's also good for learning new information. Here we have the auto-tiering. So what you can read here is that you actually have 3 tiers if you enable this. You have ultra high speed, which is your SSD, high speed and capacity. So what happens is that frequently accessed data is automatically moved to the fastest disks, while infrequently accessed data is moved to the slower high capacity disks. And to enable Q-tier, you must have at least one SSD installed and you need to have at least 4 gigabytes of memory. And you can also click on the disks here, and here it gets pretty interesting because here you can actually see where the disks are located in your NAS. So you just simply click on them and you can see the exact disk with their speeds and their temperature and their health. Here on the left side, you can see the different snapshots. But enough talking about that. You can go to security, for example, if you want to enable two-factor authentication and other things. For example, if you want to enable connections from specific IP addresses and. Here, when we go to the file station, you can see the organization of your folder. If you don't want to access it like this and you're on your local network, for example, my NAS is not available from a public network, so you can simply open your files. I have it mapped under network, so under network you should see the NAS, and you can just click through the folders here like you're used to. Here we already were in the storage and snapshots. Here is the help center. We've also visited that, and here are some other apps. We can go to the app center. So here are all the apps you have installed and you can install. So here, when you look at all the apps you can install, I think that you'll find something that fulfills your needs. Here we can see a lot of databases, a lot of virtualization software, some developer tools, antivirus software. So there's everything you would probably need, like installing Python, for example. And a lot of security features, a lot of security apps. So here on the left side, you can also see the categories. So if you're, for example, only looking for developer tools or you want some entertainment, for example, so some media streaming, then you can look it up here. There's a lot of different options here and there is no time to go through all of them. I wanted to show you some basics, so here they are. You also have the tab for privileges, where you can set up different users, different user groups, and basically do all the user management there.
I'd like to talk about the design for a bit as well, because it is quite long, as you can see, and it looks like a square from the front, and then it's quite long. It weighs around 1.6 kilograms, it is 15 centimeters wide and 14 centimeters high, and it also has LED indicators on the front, so you can see in which status the discs are and what the system is currently doing. I think that it's a weird thing to have resting on your desktop, so I guess you should find a nice place for it. What's great is that it does not overheat, at least not in my case. So I have it put in a shelf, and you might be like, you know, there's a fan and it has to overheat. No, it's actually totally fine, so please don't worry about it and don't write comments about it. If it would overheat, I would definitely change the place for it. And with the place, I also want to talk about why I have it there or where to actually place this device, because you might be wondering, well, if it's like a PC and it's still on, it must be actually generating some sounds. And yes, I have HDDs in here, so whenever a file is accessed, you can actually hear the noise, and I'm gonna play it to you right now. So this is basically what you can hear whenever you're accessing files which are not cached. And for this reason, I have it in a separate room where I don't really care about the sound. I have it in my living room, actually. You get used to it. It's not a sound that would bother me like crazy, but it's definitely not a sound I'd like to sleep with. So I'm definitely not considering putting this into the bedroom, because I only have like two rooms where I can put it. So it's either the bedroom or the living room. So the living room it is. What I like about this is that it's super easy to open, super easy to access all the discs, so you can switch them up pretty quickly, and everything in the UI is just so user-friendly that even if you're not familiar with any NAS system, I think that you're gonna understand what you can enable and what you can do with it. I was really blown away by the user interface. It is incredibly easy to access the files from all your devices, whether it's a TV, whether it's your laptop, or it's your phone, and they have great apps for that. For example, on my phone, I'm using the Ufile app, which basically allows me to access the files on the NAS system, and it is the number one best app I've seen for like copying data to or from. I use it every day as I'm a content creator. Whatever I film, when I cut a video and I want to publish it on my social media, I just send it or I just put it on my NAS, and then I'm ready to go from any device and I can save those files. And it's amazingly quick if you're like working on your private network. So everything is instantly copied, everything is instantly accessed, and it's a great way of being productive. And I think to me, it's definitely a better way than to have it stored somewhere on a cloud, which is not run by me. I always had everything backed up on external hard drives, but that's not a way to go. And with a NAS, you don't have to care about it whatsoever. The only thing you should care about is updating it regularly so that it's patched up, so that it's secured. So whenever there is an issue, you should always keep your system updated. If you don't want it to be accessible from a public network, then you can disable it, and so that it becomes accessible only from your private network, so only from those devices you basically trust. But the way you access the files through a public network is going to the QNAP cloud, where you see all the files and you can do whatever you desire with them. The advantage of not having external drives, but of having actually a NAS system, is that you don't have to care about the health of the data, because it is regularly accessed by the system and it does everything for you. You can sleep with a clear mind and not worry about losing your data as much. Of course, any of the disks can simply die. That's why you are actually having the RAID there, so if something happens, then you should be fine. Also, you can regularly do snapshots of the system and then basically recover to any state. I have the system for almost 9 months now, and I am very happy that I switched, that I actually got a NAS system. Unfortunately, I cannot compare it to anything else, but I wanted to give you an honest opinion from like a user's perspective and how it has helped me, and really tell you that if you're looking for a NAS storage, then this is the one you should be looking for, because it basically has nothing that would bother me at all, like nothing. There's nothing I'm missing. It has awesome apps, whether it's for multimedia or it's for what you're doing there for like virtual machines or hosting or whatever you want. Qfile, my absolute favorite app. I'm using it like all the time and it's amazing. Like whenever I want to show anyone pictures from like a holiday or something, I could simply like access the file and within seconds, not even within seconds, like within milliseconds, I can see the pictures and I don't have to wait. Like, well, I can access the photos from anywhere. I don't have to keep anything on my phone anymore. I just don't care. I just always put it on my NAS so that I can always have enough storage on my phone or on my MacBook, and I can access the files whenever I want. So anytime, like I need a doc, like I need a CV, or I need a photo from like any photo shoot I had, or I need a doc regarding something, like regarding your current job or anything you don't really like keep on your device because it's some information that you know you have, you know you want to keep it, you're not accessing it regularly, that's a great way to like feel, yes, I know that I have it because it's on my NAS. So you don't have to worry about, oh, I have this on my phone, maybe it's on my Mac, maybe it's on my desktop or wherever it is. No, it's on my NAS. So that's everything I wanted to tell you. I hope so. I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope I'll see you next time. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. It would help me a lot. And I hope I'll see you soon. Bye!